We as Americans have a duty to take care of the most vulnerable among us, especially our seniors. I want you to think about someone that's elderly that you care about. Think about your mom or your dad or maybe your grandma or your grandpa, or if you're really lucky, your great-grandma or your great-grandpa. How do you want them to spend the waning years of their life? Who's going to take care of them? How do you want them to live? Folks, we as Americans, we have a duty to our seniors. These are the people who raised us. These are the people who built everything that we see around us. It will be my honor as your Congresswoman to make sure that we protect the benefits coming to our seniors, to make sure that Social Security and Medicare are rock solid benefits that our seniors and our elderly populations can count on. I will defend them from partisan attacks and protect and expand them to the people who need them the most. Folks, we're looking down the pipe at what some experts call the silver tsunami. And by 2022, we need 1 million new home healthcare workers because 90% of our seniors want to retire and live in their homes. But we don't have enough home healthcare workers to care for them. We need to have a national program that recruits and trains home health workers to care for our seniors and to care for our disabled populations. And then we need to make sure that we're paying them a living wage and giving them the benefits they need to keep them in those jobs. In the last 5 years, we've lost 4,000 people nationwide who work for our Social Security Administration. In our Reading office right now, we have 14 open desks. And the people who should be sitting at those desks are the people who work with seniors every day to help them understand their benefits and help make sure that they're getting what they've paid into the system back out of it. All of their lives, our seniors have paid their money into the Social Security system. And it's our duty to give that back to them.